Good evening to all of you. Today we discuss our week third lecture, that is determinants. And today we discuss the sum properties of the determinant. Okay. So there are three students, Abu Bakr Hussain, Fahad and Muhammad Baksh. Okay, so I'm going to upload the PowerPoint slides. With the help of PowerPoint slides, I will show you. Wait a minute. Okay, I will wait a few minutes, 2 or 3 minutes, then I will start. Have you seen these slides? And I upload these slides on your blackboard. And okay. Fahad, do you have a mic or not? Do you have a speaker? I will give you the mic for a few minutes. If you have a mic, then speak it. Okay, so right. Basically, I want to discuss that tomorrow we have a meeting with the YD. Basically, yesterday we have a meeting with the YD, but due to some reasons, the meeting is postponed. So tomorrow we have a meeting with the Wiley. So that's why we will discuss your matter with them. So let's see what happens. And I will show these mails to them that you discuss, Fahad, as you discuss with customer care. I will show these mails to them. Then let's see what they told. So now I'm going to start. I think it's 7:05. I think rest of the students maybe come, then they can join. I will repeat later. So this is today's our objective. Today's our lecture, that is determinant Today we discuss determinants, minor, cofactor, and adjoint of the matrix. And then I will discuss evaluate of the determinant of the matrix by cofactor expansion. After that, I will discuss determine the inverse of the matrix using adjoint. And then after, I will discuss solve the system of linear equations using Cramer's rule. And after that, I will discuss use row reduction to evaluate the determinant. So these things I also discuss in our face-to-face lecture. Now, with the help of PowerPoint slides, I will discuss one by one these things. So first of all, what is determinants? There are determinants by cofactor expansion evaluate by determinant by row reduction properties of the determinants. So what is the determinant? A determinant is a real number associated with a square matrix. This is the definition of the determinant. Determinant of a 2 by 2 matrix, this is the determinant of 2 by 2 matrix. The number 2 is row and number 2 is column. This is a 2 by 2 matrix. And if we are going to solve this determinant, a real number is defined by determinant of A, then if we are going to solve this, so we have to multiply AD multiply by CD. This is a rule to solve this determinant, and it is equal to AD minus CD. So determinants are commonly used to test if a matrix is invertible and to find the area of a certain geometric figures. There are so many use of the determinants. So how to determine of a matrix is invertible or not? So this is the one question. So with the help of the determinant, we can find whether the matrix is invertible or not invertible. The following is often used to determine the square matrix is invertible. So a square matrix is invertible if and only if the determinant of A does not is equal to zero. This property I was told you in week second, and I was giving you the example of this. If determinant of A is equal to zero, then it is not invertible, and it is not equal to zero, then it is invertible. So this is one definition. So I will give you one example. So here there is an example. Determine if A inverse is exists by computing the determinant of the matrix. So we have two questions. Question number A is given and B is given. Now find the whether the question is determine if A inverse exists or not. You have a question. Just check whether A inverse exists or not. So the property of existing A inverse is that we just check whether the determinant is zero or not. So we check determinant of A is equal to 5 multiplied by minus 1 and 9 multiplied by 4. So we check, we get a minus 31, and it is not zero. As we check that it is not is equal to zero. So it means that the determinant is A inverse is exist. When it is zero, then we say that A inverse does not exist. So in this case, we got the value minus 31. It means A inverse does exist. Now in second case, B part, as we are going to solve this determinant, so we know the formula to solve the determinant. 9 multiplied by minus 1 and 3 multiplied by minus 3. So we get a 0. So directly we say that A inverse does not exist. So this is the procedure. And we are not going to proceed further to find the A inverse or not. So because of that is a long method to find the A inverse. It is just we stop only here and say that A inverse does not exist. So next thing is we have to know what are minors and cofactors. So we know we can find the determinants of 2 by 2 matrix, but can we find the determinants of 3 by 3 matrix, 4 by 4 matrix, and 5 by 5 matrix? In order to find the determinants of a large square matrix, we need to understand the concepts of the minors and cofactors. So first of all, we tell you what are the minors and what are the cofactors. So the minors and cofactor. The minor is denoted by Mij for element Aij in the square matrix A. A is a real number, compute by performing the following steps. So step number one is delete the ith row and jth column from the matrix A. So if we are going to find the for example, if we have A11, and so it says delete this row and this column, so and rest of the column we can find. So step number two, Mij is equal to the determinant of the resulting matrix. That is equal to any this will, whatever we find over here, that is the Mij. And the cofactor is denoted by Aij. For Aij is defined by Aij is equal to minus 1 to the power I plus j into Mij. This is called the cofactor. This is the formula of the cofactor. Now with the help of examples we see how we can find the minors and cofactors. So let us proceed. For there is a example, find the minor M11 and cofactor A11. So for a matrix A, for example, here is a matrix is given minus 8, 0, 4, and 4, minus 6, 7, 2, minus 3, and 5. So first of all, we have to find the minor. So to obtain M11, begin by crossing out the first row and the first column. So we just cross this thing, because if we want the minor of minus 8, so we cross this row and this column. So the rest of the minor is equal to, so minus 6 multiplied by 5, we retain only this matrix, this determinant. So what we do, we are going to multiply this, and minus 6 into 5 and 7 into 3. So what we get is equal to 9. The minor is equal to minus 9. So since we are going to find the cofactor. So the formula of cofactor is minus 1 to the power I plus j. Here we have 1, I plus j is 1 1, so we are going to add this thing 1 plus 1. So minus 1 rest to the power 1 plus 1 M11, and now we have a value M11 is 9, minus 9, so the value of A11 is minus 1 is square and minus 9. So minus 1 square, the value of minus 1 is square is 1, and the value of minus 9 is 9, so our answer is minus 9. So this is our answer. So this is the answer of our cofactor of first element. It is the minor of first element. This is the cofactor of first element. Now we similarly in the same matter we find the another and other elements. Now similarly we find the cofactor of second element A12. And similarly, we find the cofactor minor of A12, and then find the cofactor of A12. Similarly, after that, I find the minor of A13, then find the cofactor of A13. Similarly, after that, I want the minor of A21, then after I find the value of cofactor of A21. So from this procedure, we can move further and further. So let's see how to find the matrix of any square matrix. So how to find the determinant of any square matrix? If we are given a square matrix, then how we can find the matrix? Once we know how to obtain a cofactor, we can find the determinant of any square matrix. You may pick any row or column, but the calculations is easy. Easier if some element is the selected row or column is zero. So determinant of a matrix using the method of cofactors. Multiply each element in a row or column of a matrix by a cofactor. The sum of products is equal to the determinant. So for Aij, Aij, and for row Fij, Aij and Aij. So example of finding the determinant by the cofactor. So this find the determinant of A. This is the matrix is given. This is the same matrix as we discussed in previous minus 8, 0, 4, 4, minus 6, 7. Now to find the determinant of A, we can select any row or column. If we begin with expanding our first column of A, so we can expand either row wise or we can expand either column wise. In a class, I show you in the from the both sides. In a face to face class, I show you we can expand this matrix from the row wise and or from the column wise. So we know when we are going to solve this thing. Then we, you know, first one we apply the plus sign, after that we apply minus sign, then after we apply the plus sign. So this is the procedure we can solve, we can open the bracket. Similarly, in the case of column, we use plus, then minus, then plus. So in this matter, we can solve, we can open the bracket. So similarly, over here we can use the determinant of A is A11 is equal to minus 9, as we see in the previous example, we get the minus 9 over here. So similarly, A21 is this, minus 12, A31 is 24. So determinant of A is equal to minus 8 multiplied by minus 9, and this total, the determinant of A is 72. So this is the method we can find the value of the determinant. So this lecture we can find the adjoint. This topic belongs to the previous topic, week 2 topic that we discussed earlier. So that's why there is no need, but I discuss over here. The adjoint of the matrix can be found by taking the transpose of the matrix of the cofactor from A. In our previous example, we have find the cofactors of A11, A22, A31. If we continue to solve the rest of the cofactors of the matrix, namely these are cofactors A12, A13, these are the cofactors of the matrix. So for example, if we have a matrix, then these are the cofactors A11. In previous example, as I showed you, these are the cofactors. A11 is a cofactor, A21 is a cofactor, A31 is a cofactor. So these are the cofactors. From this matrix, we can find the cofactors. So let us assume that this matrix, this is a cofactors matrix. This is a cofactor matrix. For let's say AC, this is a AC matrix, yani a cofactor matrix. This is a cofactor matrix. A11, A12, A13, A21. So the definition of the adjoint is we convert a row into, we can take the transpose, we can by taking the transpose of the matrix cofactor. So by taking the transpose is using the transpose, the row is converted into the column. So it is called the transpose. So we do here. So what we do here, the transpose of 3 by 3 matrix of a cofactor from them is called the adjoint. and it's denoted by adjoint of A. So adjoint of A is the cofactor of the matrix. So we observe that here is the previous row, the element is A12. It is the transpose of that. In the previous matrix, as we see here, A12 lie over here. Here lie, but this lie over here. Any row become. Let us see in the previous. What is A12? Where is A12? As we see in the previous, A12 over here. This is, and A13 over here. So in our next example, these are in the column. So as we see, so these are in the A12 and A13 inside the column. So every row become every column. This is called the transpose of the matrix. So the transpose of the cofactor is called the 3x3 cofactor from A. It's called the adjoint of A. So this is the formula of adjoint. What we are going to do with the adjoint, we can use it to help to find the A inverse. If A inverse is element, if A is a invertible matrix, of course, if we don't have A inverse, if A is not invertible, then we cannot find the A inverse. This is the first theorem. So the formula of A inverse is, if A is an invertible matrix, then A inverse is 1 upon determinant of A and adjoint of A. So we have to find the adjoint of A with the help of the cofactor. If we don't find the cofactor, then we cannot find the adjoint of A. Now there is a note. The square matrix A is invertible if and only if determinant of A is 0. So it says that this is a theorem that we discuss in our second slide. A square matrix is invertible if and only if determinant of A is equal to 0. Yani determinant of A is equal to 0, then we say A is invertible. Determinant of A is equal to 0, then we say A is invertible. If it is not equal to 0, then we say it is not invertible. So the second note, if A is n cross n triangular matrix, then determinant of A is a product of the entries on the main diagonal of the matrix, theorem 2.1.3. So this is another theorem. So the inverse of 2x2 matrix is A. If this is given, then A is equal to 1 upon determinant of A, and B, A just we just reverse it, AB minus BC, then just reverse this thing, and 2x2 matrix we can find the inverse like this, and rest of the matrix 3x3, 4x3 we have to use the cofactor method. So next, a 2x2 matrix, evaluate the determinant of this. We are given a 2x2 matrix and we can evaluate the determinant by multiplying this thing. We can multiply this thing and we can evaluate the determinant. So how to compute the higher order determinant? So it is the same method. First of all, we have to find the minus and then find the cofactors. So these are some what is adjoint? Okay, I will tell you once again. In the slides are coming, more slides are coming. Then I will tell you once again what are the adjoints. Adjoint. This is some examples of what are the minus. So I'm telling you once again what are the minus. If we have a given, there is a determinant is given. So we take the minor of first element M11. This is A11. This is A11. The minor of first element is this. This is the minor of first element. Similarly, what we then we cross first row and first column, and rest of the thing is the minor of first element. Similarly, the minor of second element, so how we calculate? We cross this row and this column, we can calculate the minor of this. Similarly, we can calculate the minor of this thing. So we cross this column and this row, and rest of the thing is the minor of A13. So these are called, these are denoted by M, M11, M12, M3, M13. So the cofactor the cofactor ij, cofactor of A, or the cofactor of Aij, is defined by Aij is equal to minus 1 which is rest to the power I plus j Mij. So this is with the help of, this is the procedure to open the determinant. If we are given this matrix, then this is the procedure as I told you earlier in previous slides. First we start from the positive sign, then we move further, plus minus plus minus plus. If we go on the column wise, then on the same matter we proceed further, plus minus plus minus. So this, in this way we open the bracket. So over here it is says that by, if we have a 3 by 3 matrix, then we are going to find the cofactor. So we start from A11, then it is A11, you said is its capital A11, and if we are going to multiply A12, then it is A12, and from this method we can open the whole determinant. Let us assume we get this types of thing. So find the determinant of A. The question is find the determinant of this given matrix. The cofactor expansion along the first row of A. 3 by 3 determinants expressed in terms of 3 2 by 2 determinants. 4 by 2 determinants expressed in terms of 4 3 by 3 determinants. So these are some theorems. So there are some properties of the determinants. The property of a determinant, one is, if there are two or three properties of the determinant that I discuss in face to face class. If I am going to the property number one, if I am going to interchange any two rows or two columns of the determinant, for example, then the sign of the determinant is changed. So for example, if we have this row, if we are going to change this row, minus 3 and this row, if we are going to interchange these two columns, 0 minus 1 1 and 3 minus 3 0 5 4. So in matrix B, we interchange over here to here, then what the result is, determinant of A is equal to minus determinant of B. So the sign is changed. If we change any two rows or any two columns, then the sign of the determinant is changed. Let's see another example. If we are going to change these two rows, for example, row 1 is this and the another row is this. So if we are going to change these two rows, then what will become, the answer will be determinant of A is equal to minus determinant of C. So this is the property of the determinant. We put the minus sign over here. So then property number 2, this is the second property. Property number 2 says that if the two columns or the two rows are identical or proportional, then the value of the determinant is zero. This says that if two things are same or the proportional, then the value of the determinant is zero, either in column or in row. So this is the example of the column. Now in row, I say that this row -6, 2, 2, 4 and -6, 2, 2, 4 are equal. So directly we say that the value of the determinant is zero. So this is one property of the determinant. So this property we have to remember. So property number third. Property number third, kith row plus jth column. So if we have two row, if we have a determinant A and we are going to multiply, if we are going to add these two rows and multiply with some kth factor, then there is no any change between two matrix, two determinant. The value of the determinant is same. For example, if we are going to multiply column 2 multiplied by 2 and subtract from column 3, then the value is always same. So in similar way, if we are going to multiply row and double row or the two row, then the value of the determinant is same. So these are the property of the determinant. So over here I show you how we are going to multiply this thing. For example, in column 2, if you are going to multiply by 5 column 2, to minus 5 over here, 5 4 is 20 and 5 2 is 10, then determinant of B is equal to 5 times determinant of A, because if we multiply 5 over here, so that is why we can say that. So these are some properties of the determinant. Ith row B is equal to ith row column. These are some properties of the determinants. So there are two types of matrix. One matrix is called the upper triangular matrix, and the another type of matrix is called the lower triangular matrix. So the upper triangular matrix is zero below the main diagonal. If we have a main diagonal of, this is the main diagonal, and below the main diagonal are zero, is called the upper triangular matrix. These are zero. So this matrix is called the upper triangular matrix. And if we have the matrix in which it is called the lower triangular matrix, because of over here the zeros is upper side, so we say that it is a lower triangular matrix, because of triangle form in the lower side, that is why we say it is a lower triangular matrix. And over here we observe that triangle made in the upper side, that's why we say upper triangular matrix, upper triangular matrix. So the rest of the part are zero and only diagonal elements are given. So determinant of triangular is equal to product of diagonal. I mean, determinant of the triangular is equal to product of the diagonal element. You mean, this is determinant is given. Here is given some examples. If given a matrix and its transpose, in a transpose, what will become, row become column. here row becomes column, 1, 2, 3 become 1, 2, 3, and similarly rest of the rows. So this is the transpose of the matrix. So A transpose, and transpose is equal to A. This is the property of the transpose, and C A transpose is equal to A into T. T transpose, A B transpose is equal to A transpose B transpose, and A B whole transpose is equal to B transpose A transpose. The n cross n matrix A is invertible if and only if determinant of A does not is equal to 0. So these are examples. Find the A inverse. So this is the upper triangular matrix. If we observe that, this is the upper triangular matrix, and this is example, find the A inverse, and it is say the values are given. Determinant of AB is equal to determinant of A into determinant of A, AB. Any mod of AB is equal to mod of A and mod of AB. So A inverse is equal to 1 upon A. So now the last topic is, that is a Cramer's rule. So Cramer's rule is says that if we have a system of equations, there are so many x1, x unknown. If we have n unknown and n variables, then we have to find the values of x, y, z. So there are so many ways to solve this type of linear equation, but there is a one way to solve, that is called the Cramer's rule. So if we have so many equations, like 1, 2, 3 equations and 3 unknowns, then how we can solve this type of equation? So it says that Cramer's rule says that you have to write the system of linear equation in the determinant form. So first you write the coefficient matrix, and then you write the variables x, y, z, and then you write the right value of the right hand side, that is written. And then after solving this, so you get the value of x1. You get the value of x1. So how you get the value of x1? So to calculate the x1, you have to multiply, you have to write determinant of this and determinant of A. And then first you introduce right hand side on the first, and second time you put the right hand side second, and the third time you put right hand side on the third point, and rest on and follow on. So in this way we can calculate the value of x1, x2, x3. And in the denominator there are same thing, mod A, mod A, mod A, the same thing. So this, I give you one example. So solve the system. If we are given a system, two equations and two unknowns, and we have to find the value of x1 and y1. So there is a question is given, 2 by 2 question, 3x plus 5y 2 and 3 plus 2y is equal to 1. And one another question, using the Cramer's rule to solve the system. There are three equations given, one equation, two equation, and three equation. So first, to solve the Cramer's rule, we have to write the coefficient matrix, that 1, 4, and 5. Then we are going to solve. So what happens? It is, I think, just like this. So I think I'm not solving this thing. So we can solve in this matrix 1, 0, 2. 431 and 351, we can solve, no, in the previous slide. There are three equations and three unknowns. So we can solve this thing by a Cramer's rule. So I think after that, after five or six slides, I will show you how can solve the solve by Cramer's rule. So let us see. It is the adjoint matrix. Hope you understand very well. Another method to find the inverse of the matrix. You understand it, and what is Cramer's rule? In this matrix, I will show you how. Over here, I can explain. Yes. So use the Cramer's rule to solve this x plus 4y is equal to. We have 2 by 2 equations, two equations and two unknowns. Here we have x plus 4y, and this is, and just after that we will take the 3 by 3 matrix. So first of all, I write the coefficient matrix, that is 1 and 4 and 2 and 9. And then after I solve this matrix, and then I find the value of, first of all, I write the determinant of A. So after that, determinant of A is, over here I calculate or not. I think whenever. So first of all, I write the value of C. E is equal to determinant of C1, C2, B1, B2. So C1 is our 3, 5. First, I write the right hand side over here, and then B1, B2. Our next thing is over here. This thing is, I write over here. Then the value of determinant is 7. Then after I use F, so I write the right hand side second time, 3, 5, and first thing is same over here. First thing is same over here, and then calculate the determinant over here, and then finally I write the main determinant, A1, A2, and when is 1, 2 and 4 and 9. That is the main determinant, the value of the coefficient matrix I write over here. So that main determinant is A. So in this matrix, I, for example, in our face to face class, I told you it is A, and it is A1, and it is A2. It is A2. Okay. It is A2, it is A1, and it is A. Yes. So the value of x1 in our class, I told you the value of x1 is equal to determinant of a1 and upon determinant of a. I think this determinant of a. The notations are changed in this slide, so don't be confused. So this is E and F and D. So the solution is X is equal to E upon D, yani determinant of A1, determinant of A1 upon determinant of A, determinant of A. This is, that is 7 by 1 is equal to 7. So this is the value of X. And similarly, the value of y is determinant of A2, determinant of A2 divided by determinant of A. So don't confuse with the symbols. So I use this symbol in a class, face to face class, so it is easy. Don't go with these slides. So the value of y is equal to minus 1. So in this way we can solve the Cramer's rule. So I think this is the main thing of today's discussion, Cramer's rule. Now I think most of the topic is complete. Now we see what are the limitations of the method, the methods of the cofactors of the Cramer's rule. These are some rules you read yourself. A substantial number of arithmetic operations are needed to compute determinant of a large matrix. The cofactor of method calculate determinant of n by n matrix, and n is greater than 2 generally involves more than factorial n multiplication operations. The time and cost required to solve the linear system that involves thousands. These are some things you read yourself. Now the third point is evaluating the determinant by the reducing the matrix to row echelon form. So this is the third point of today's lecture. So how we can calculate the determinant by reducing the row reduced form. So let's look at a matrix, where if it is a matrix, I show you in a face-to-face class, our target is to convert into upper triangular matrix. We have to convert this matrix into upper triangular matrix or row echelon form. Then after we find the determinant of one. So we can find the determinant by reducing it to row echelon form. We want a leading one in a row one. So we want in place of 0, we want 1. And rest of the element, I want 0 in blue. So what I have to do in place of first, I want 0. So I move this row to over here. I move row 1 to, I exchange row 2 to row 1. And I apply the operation row 2 and row 1 exchange. I exchange row 2 row 1. So with this operations, I got this value 111 and 0031. So but if we are going to interchange the rows, then you have to apply the minus sign over here. Now our next target is what I want to do. Our next target is I want to remove 3 from here, and I want 0 in this place. So to put the 0 in this place, I have to apply a operation. So I have to apply the operation R3. I have to apply the operation in R3. R3 is equal to R3 minus 3 times R1. So with the help of this operation, we get the 0 in this place. So with the help of this operation, we get the 0. So here is written, we want a leading diagonal 1 in row 2. We can take a common factor 3 from row 2 to accomplish this. So over here we get it. And one by one we get it. This 0. So now our next step is we want 0 in this place. So apply some operation, and with the help of operation we get 0 over here. Now after we want 0 below the leading diagonal 1 in row. So we can add a row 2 to row 3 to accomplish this row, a row replacement. So lastly, I want 1 in this place. So apply any operation or divide by 3 by minus 5. So if I am going to divide this or take common outside, then we get this thing. So finally I get it is converted into upper triangular matrix. As we observe that it is a mean diagonal, and below diagonal there is a 0 0. So as I told you, it is a upper triangular matrix. So our aim is to convert it into upper triangular matrix. When it convert into upper triangular matrix, and it is called the row echelon form. And whatever the value we get on the left hand side, it is the value of the determinant. So this is the value of the determinant, and the answer of the determinant is minus 3 into 5 by 3 is equal to 3 to 3 cancel out, and minus sign to minus sign we get the 5. So this is the solution of to find the determinant using row reduction forms. So these are some more examples. So the main topics are covered. Now I will give you some examples of these are we conclude the determinant use let us to with the help of cofactor we can find the determinant first to this element, then to this element, 2 and then 3, and over here we can find the value of the determinant. The value of the determinant is 0, or expand down in the second column wherever we want we can expand this. Now another example, using a row or column with many zeros. So there is another example, pivoting condensation. It says that by the arrows you can understand these are just examples. Just practice this question, don't see inside the PowerPoint slide, just practice on your copy and pen, and whenever you get some problem, some confusion, then on that time you see this PowerPoint slide, then it will be helpful for you. So from this you can understand how we can solve the matrix, how we can find, how we can convert this matrix. Let's see, we convert this matrix into upper triangular matrix. This is the main diagonal, and these things are zero. So this it is the upper triangular matrix, and the value of the determinant is this. So these are some examples. This is the end of the lecture. Now prepare it, and hopefully you submit your assignment on the blackboard, and whatever is your problem then discuss me. Hope you understand it. If you have any question then discuss me, then tell me. Yes, the deadline of assignment is 25th of February. I write it on the blackboard. Any other questions? Wait a minute. Hello. وعليكم السلام. بس دعاء الحمد لله ميت جنبي عشان نفيس عشان بيت ام 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 hopefully you understand. Now you submit your assignment before 25th of February. By mistake it is written on 25th of March, so don't confuse with it, and submit it before 25th of February. Okay, so any other question? Okay. Okay. Good night. Take care.